My name is William Meyer. I have a T4 injury to my spinal cord. I have no feeling from the mid-chest down. Gary Bader and Sons Feed Yard is the name of our farm. It's my grandma, my grandpa, my parents, my aunt and uncles, and then me and my first cousin Reagan. We can hold about 10,000 head of feedlot cattle here, and we have lots of other ground, and we raise our own corn and alfalfa, and we have lots of pasture. My accident, it was March 7th, 2015. I was on my way home late that night, and I really don't remember anything. Just kind of went off in a ditch, and then I hit a driveway that goes into a cornfield and rolled my vehicle 5 or 6 times, the investigators told me, and I was ejected out of it. I did not have my seatbelt on. I broke my back in 2 spots, in my neck in 1. From surgery, I was in St. Francis for 10 days, and I went to Madonna. It was very intense therapy, and they were very great there. It was a great place to go. And I learned pretty much how to live from my wheelchair there. And I went from working 60 to 70 hours a week at the co-op to my injury, and then to going 2 to 3 to 4 hours of physical therapy a day, and that was it. I mean, that was a big difference, and it really got to me that that's all I could do. Just not being able to do work, not being able to work was the main obstacle that I had to get over. The first time I heard about VR was when Rod Petersen and J.D. Simmons came and visited me at Madonna, and they told me about all the different things that they can provide and help with.
My name is Rod Petersen. I work with Nebraska AgrAbility. It's a division of Easter Seals. We work with farmers and ranchers with disabilities in Nebraska. We first met William at Madonna Rehabilitation Center in Lincoln.
That first meeting is to let people know about Nebraska VR, AgrAbility, and ATP, so that they are aware that their life hasn't ended, their career has not necessarily ended. It's changed, but it hasn't ended. And William, from day one, we knew that. I mean, it was pretty apparent he was going to continue, whether we're there or not, he was going to find a way.
I think in all the years that I've done this, I've never been associated with anyone that has the drive, the attitude that William has. The first time we met him, he said, you know, I've accepted what's happened. I'm going to make the best with what I've got. And when we interviewed him and when we showed him what assistive technology could be available to him, he was even more encouraged. And I think that really solidified his drive.
Rod has definitely been a life changer for me. He's told me numerous pieces of equipment. It meant the world to me. It told me that I could get back to doing the things that I did before, and or most of the things.
We have the farm expertise, the agricultural expertise, to make the recommendations for a client with a disability to succeed. And then VR funds those assistive technology recommendations. And in the end, we work together, and it's worked quite well, and we've got a lot of success stories.
AgrAbility, they're already working on job site modifications. Assistive technology will then come in and work in usually the home modifications. Our goal is for accessibility to help that person get out of their home and go to work.
ATP has helped me in numerous ways. They've showed me my lift from Life Essentials, which is definitely a Life Essentials piece of equipment. My seat for my pickup that helps me get in and out. My hydro bed, and then my saddle.
William is a cowboy, and he loves to ride horses.
This operation depends very much on horses. And they move cattle, they check cattle, they ride pens. And when we first sat down and did the assessment with William, there was no doubt he wanted to get back on a horse.
William and his mom, Tanya, did a ton of research, found out that there was an orthopedic saddle out there, and we purchased the saddle.
We lined him up with the assistive technology that he needed and the things that he needed to be successful, but it's his attitude and his drive that has really been the factor that has made him successful.
Without Nebraska VR, I definitely wouldn't be doing probably half the things that I am today.
Independence is a big part of what we're doing, is to help that person not only have the ability to do it, but to have the ability to do it independently.
William's attitude from day one, from the day we met him, has been nothing but positive. The I can has always been there. He has just recovered marvelously.
Getting back to doing what I love was one of the hardest things that I felt when I was first in the hospital, just to be able to go back and get back on a horse and get back in the equipment and get back to doing the things that I used to do is just amazing.